We'll perhaps have one more look at this amazing incident at the beginning of Exodus 3, the meeting between Moses and Jesus, the angel of the Lord. And it's that little detail that is in verse 5, when the angel of the Lord says to Moses, "Don't draw near this place. Take your sandals off your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground." The earth itself is holy where Moses is standing. And so he's instructed to take off his shoes. And we wonder, what is that about? Well, first of all, let's just appreciate this idea that the living God, the God of heaven and earth, is standing upon the earth, some the soil, and where he is present, it's as if there's a zone around him of holiness. And there's this bigger idea, and it comes in a way at the end of Leviticus. Leviticus has this idea that, again, where the Lord is dwelling at the center of the ancient church camp, that is the most holy place, the really holy zone where he dwells. And then the camp is a kind of not so much holy but clean, and then outside the camp unclean. But when you get to the end of Leviticus, there's this idea that people can make their own domestic environment holy, dedicate the things in their life, the things they possess, their own environment, their own home, holy places, as if there's this vision that the Lord has that his presence at the center of church life can sort of be an expanding thing, as if holiness can go out via church people. And then I suppose we're left thinking, but what if the whole world became a holy place? And then you'll remember in 2 Peter chapter 3, there's this idea of the cleansing of the whole universe by fire, the burning away of all that is unclean and the demonic powers. And then it will be the home of righteousness, the idea that the whole creation will be a holy place, fully indwelt by the presence of the Lord in fullness, and everywhere is holy. So just this little sense here that the earth itself is not like an evil or unholy thing. The earth isn't. And that actually, when the Lord is present, we see in Genesis that way in which there's a kind of alienation, a separation between heaven and earth. But actually, earth can be holy. And just this idea that the ground on which the Lord is standing is holy. And Moses is also invited, or is in fact standing, into holy ground. So that's something deep to think about. The idea that the earth can be holy when the Lord is dwelling there. But then this idea of, why does he have to take his shoes off? There's something about that idea. Is it like we take our shoes off perhaps when we come into a home because we don't want to bring dirt and defilement in, and there's a sense of leave your shoes there because we don't want uncleanness brought into it, something of that. But I remember Steve Levy says that the other thing we do is when we take our shoes off, it means we're not going anywhere. Like if you come into the house, you take your shoes off because you're coming to stay now. And it's as if maybe the Lord's saying to Moses, take your shoes off. This is holy ground. You're engaged with my business now. You're coming into my home, my dwelling area. Take your shoes off and I will tell you when to go, where to go, and how to go. There's a sense now you're not going anywhere for a while. You're in my dwelling. You need to listen to me and I'm going to commission you. All these ideas are in there, but it is worth just chewing on it, isn't it? The whole idea of having bare feet in the Bible, it's worth just following through something to do with feet. There's that amazing incident where the Lord washes the feet of his disciples as he's preparing to die on the cross. All this is worth thinking about, but I like that thought. Moses, take your shoes off. You're not going anywhere till I send you.